Good afternoon and welcome to Holy Trinity Church for our noonday prayer. Today we celebrate the life of St. Luke the Evangelist. Great Spirit, whose breath is felt in the soft breeze and whose life surges through the socket and screen, we seek your strength in the midst of the day. May we and the peoples of the world work in dignity and walk in the beauty of the day. Blessed be God, the Father of life. Blessed be God, the giver of light. Blessed be God, the bestower of skills. Illumine our hearts, O Lord, implant in us a desire for your truth. May all that is false within us flee. Let us say the words for seven sentences of Psalm 147 together. Hallelujah! How good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant it is to honor him with praise. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He counts the number of the stars and calls them all by their names. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. There is no limit to his wisdom. The Lord lifts up the lowly, but casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God upon the harp. Praise to the holy and undivided Trinity, one God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. I do not call you servants, but friends, because I have known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. Alleluia, alleluia. A reading from Sirach. Honor physicians for their services, for the Lord created them, for their gift of healing comes from the Most High, and they are rewarded by the King. The skill of the physicians makes them distinguished, and in the presence of the great, they are admired. The Lord created medicines out of the earth, and the sensible will not despise them. And he gave skill to human beings that he might be glorified in his marvelous work. By them, the physician heals and takes away pain. The pharmacist makes a mixture for them. God's works will never be finished, and from him health spreads all over the earth. My child, when you are ill, do not delay, but pray to the Lord, and he will heal you. Give up your faults and direct your hands rightly, and cleanse your heart from all sin. Then give the physician his place, for the Lord created him. Do not let him leave you, for you need him. There may come a time when recovery lies in the hands of physicians, for they too pray to the Lord, and he grant them success in diagnosis and healing for the sake of preserving life. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Thanks be to God. Let us hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. Let our cry come to you. Let us pray. God of storm and rain cloud, hail and thunder and flood, in darker days we see your awesome power and recognize our own weakness. God of sunshine and warm breezes, slow moving streams and blossoming trees, in lighter days we see your overwhelming love and recognize our own belovedness. Help us to recognize you within the elements of your created world and be grateful. Hear us, gracious Lord. God, who shines the light of resurrection even into the darkness of death, in the midst of darkness in our world, kindle a fire that all may see your glory. Burn brightly in the world around us so that we may see your work and hear your call. Burn in our hearts too, so that we may know how to answer your call. Hear us, gracious Lord. Loving God, we see all around the evidence of your love and your loving provision for our needs. Yet there are others who lack life's basic essentials. Grant a spirit of responsibility to us and to all who work to correct inequality. Help us not to become immune to the suffering of others. Hear us, gracious Lord. Gracious God, you know and care for each one of us deeply and intimately. Be with those who are special, have special need of your care, especially those who we now name. Kathleen, Gail, Lena May, Hoxie, Doreen, David, Emily, Matthew, Mary, Tony, Alan, Barbara, Leah and Kiera, Jeffrey, Jonathan, Carol, Nina Kinney, Simonson, Kindem, and Redmond families, Susan and Lucas Thompson, Jill, Angerman family, Miles family, Wayne, Amanda, Byron, Gary W., the Farnworth family, and the Clayton family. We give thanksgivings for the birth of Ember Snow White, daughter of Sky, and for Emily's successful second hip replacement. We pray for the departed, Jody Matson Coney, Leonard Angerman, Tony Mills, for all who have died during this pandemic, Derek Gary Thompson, Joseph Michael Clayton, Clem Tillian, and Bill Hudson. Please add your petitions and intercessions at this time. With grateful hearts, we thank you, abundant God, for the healing and for the faithful prayers of your people, granting them grace and love and blessing for every perfect gift. Amen. Bless, O God, our world and bring us peace. Peace between neighbors, peace between kindred, peace between families, peace between nations, peace within the church, peace within our homes, the peace of Christ above all. Hear us, gracious God. We pray this in the name of the hand of God keeping us, the love of Christ shielding us, the strong spirit bathing us, the three each step abiding us. Amen. Let us pray the prayer our Christ himself taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. O God of grace and mercy, give your blessings to the Diocese of Alaska. Watch over our churches, sustain our people, strengthen our leaders. Through the Holy Spirit, guide and guard the diocese, keeping it always in your care and protection. Let us be a loving family, serving you in faithful devotion to the gospel of your Son, Jesus Christ. Give your blessings to Mark, our bishop. Give him a spirit of courage and right judgment, a spirit of knowledge and love. Let your Holy Spirit be his companion. Let your gospel be always in his thoughts. May your presence in his life be a light for all to see in every good work, for the building up of your people, and to the glory of your holy name. Give us the blessing of your example. Help us to follow in the way of Jesus today and every day. Give us compassion at the center of all we do. Compassion for ourselves as disciples still young in faith. Compassion for others as members of our own family in God. Let us become examples for others as so many others have been examples to us through your love and for the sake of your glory. Watch over all elders and brothers and sisters of the Society of Saint Simeon and Saint Anna. If any are in time of sorrow, sickness, or need, give them the touch of your healing hand. If any are in times of joy, thanksgiving, and fulfillment, give them the song of angels to praise your name. Let us be your servants in this life, just as we will be your sons and daughters in the life to come. Bless all work done today that enables the human family to be clothed, fed, and housed, to travel and to learn, to communicate and exchange wisely, to craft and celebrate in everything reflecting your glory. Good God, be with us in every experience of life. Almighty God, who inspired your servant Luke, the physician, to set forth in the gospel the love and healing power of your Son, graciously continue in your church this love and power to heal. To the praise and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
May the eternal glory shine upon us. May the Son of Mary stay beside us. May the life-giving Spirit be a canopy over us. May the eternal three-in-one be ever with us. May God bless the work of our hands.
Amen. Amen.